Hi guys, it's Susie from Thrifty Reviews for You. Today I'm doing a get ready video, and I feel like I want to talk about one of the topics that a lot of people don't talk about in the hairdresser industry is how to prevent hairdresser burnout. I got asked a question about that the other day, and I just wanted to kind of discuss it with you guys, and I'll talk about that while I'm getting ready to do my makeup. All right, first I'm going to do moisturizer on my face, and I do use the CeraVe moisturizer lotion. You use it on your body, but I feel like it adds a lot more moisture to my face as a base. So I'll go ahead and put that on first. So about hairdresser burnout, let me see. So one of the stylists was asking me about how I dealt with it. I mean, I've been doing hair for about 30 years. And I think the first time I had that burnout was when I was maybe 10 years into the business. And I did take a break for about a year, which I needed, because sometimes you need to kind of pull yourself together, you know? Especially when you're dealing with people in your chair and they, you know, they want 100% of you. It's a lot of emotional and a personal level with the clients. And sometimes when you feel like your mind isn't all there, it becomes like a chore, you know? So I would definitely say that you need to do some self-care for yourself in order to provide service for your clients. Another thing you need to do for yourself is, you know, take some time for yourself. It's a big balance when you're, you know, married and you have children. You kind of have to balance stuff in your life. I mean, I think that's part of life, period. But when you have a career and trying to, you know, balance all that stuff all at one time, it could become a lot stressful, especially if you're a single mom. And I do know a lot of single moms out there, you know, they're hustling to provide for their families, and you know, I was one of those, and actually I'm kind of going through that right now, so it's not new to me. But I know I totally had to focus on, you know, trying to get myself healthy again, because I did put myself in the hospital at one time because I was so overworked and I was highly anemic. And I had to, you know, put my career to the side for a while. Definitely is very stressful being a single mom and trying to balance your career, childcare and all that good stuff. And with my parents being elderly, I also had to add that onto my plate. I did take 5 years off, so I think that did help me kind of refocus on a lot of stuff in my life. Sorry, I like trying to talk and do my makeup at the same time. I'm usually never talking. I listen to music mostly. So I'm using e.l.f., which is a cream blush palette. I love this stuff, especially this color right here. I use that pretty much every day. All right, so I did my foundation, which is not really foundation. I did my BB cream and my Dermalogica. I mixed that together, applied that on my face with my paddle brush, which is this right here. And then did my contouring with my little dotted brush, applied that, and then blended with my medium paddle brush. All right, so Yeah, you need to do self-care. I usually, for self-care, I try to do things for myself at least once a week on my days off. Certainly I do, I get facials. You could do a facial on a budget by going to the beauty college and, you know, getting that done, because they are practicing to get their license and to pass state board. So it's good to, you know, go over there and have them experiment on you. Right now I'm doing my, what is this? Primer for my eyelids. Yeah, I went to the beauty college and got a facial with my cousin, and you know, that was like so much fun. You need to do stuff for yourself in order to give back to your clients, which I think is important. Right now, underneath my eyes, I should do more of these Get Ready With Me videos. I'm always in a hurry in the mornings when to get out the door. Now to do my base eyeshadow. So I have everything in front of me. And today I'm going to use my MAC Semi Sweet Times 9. I'm super obsessed with this shadow. This is my pretty much everyday shadow that I've been doing. So I'm gonna take the second one and just put it all over my whole eyelid with my Morphe brush. And underneath. So yeah, definitely self-care is important. You need to take time out for yourself. I feel so much more passionate about doing hair again, which is amazing. I love doing what I'm doing, which I haven't felt like that in a very long time. But definitely nice to get back into that business again. And what I like about working at Fantastic Sam's is, you know, I go in, do my job, and get out, which helps me focus on my family, especially my little one. You know, he was used to me staying at home with him for so long. Okay, now I'm using the medium brown color on the outer crease of my eye and just kind of blend that in.
Invincible.
So yeah, I hope that kind of answers everyone's questions about hairdresser burnout. It helped me refocus again on everything, because I was like super nervous when I first started working again, especially with new people I haven't worked with before, and trying to catch up on all the new trends. And you're pretty much under pressure to make everyone feel happy that sit in your chair. I mean, I definitely was pretty nervous at the time, but I'm okay now. And blend the outer underneath of your eye with the, again, that medium shadow. So my little brush on highlighting the upper eyebrow with the top lightest color, lightest shade. Just gonna fill that in a little bit. I don't really do my brows. I feel like they're so thick and they really don't need any filling in. And I feel like it's more youthful to have fuller eyebrows, but I think that's just me. I don't know. I've been like this for years. And now a little bit darker on the outer shadow. So this second to the last dark, kind of do a V. Blend in with my clean Morphe brush. And just blend that in. Another thing I enjoy doing is a you know, kind of taking care of myself is doing my own nails. I do my own gel nails at home, and that is really simple to do. If you want to watch that video, I'll go ahead and link it down below on how to do that. Almost done with my makeup. So pretty much my basic everyday type of look. And blend in with my small little pointer brush. Oh, and also exercising helps. So I try to exercise at least 3 times a week. You know, I was getting super fat for a while, and I just was so unhappy with myself. My self-esteem was just shot. So working out, I believe, makes a big difference on your mindset, for sure. All right, now for my eyeliner. All right, found my eyeliner. It's this little tiny one. I need a new one again. This is from Urban Decay, and I love this liner. So I just kind of do the outer. And you know what? To prevent from getting wrinkles on your eyes, lift that eyebrow up when you apply your liner or even eyeshadow to kind of get in there. And I like lining just the kind of outer edge. I don't really do too much. And then inside the waterline. And then I like getting the smaller brush and just kind of blending in to kind of help soften that line, because I hate harsh lines, especially when you're over 40, or actually 50. I'm 50 now, I can't believe I'm 50 years old. So you're just kind of lining the outer part. And curl my lashes. Got this Tarte lash mascara from my Ipsy bag from maybe a couple months ago. This is a really good one. My highlighter, which is the Wet n Wild Precious Petals, which is awesome, and using my SL Glam highlighting brush, just gonna dust around the upper cheekbones. Down your nose and upper cupid of your lip. Now to line my lips with my MAC Spice lipstick liner. I use this as my whole lipstick because I really like matte lips. All right, and that is it for my look. What do you think, you guys? I'm gonna fix my bangs a little bit there we go. So that is it for my look. Thanks for watching my channel. I hope my topic on hairdresser burnout helps. I know it definitely helped me by just kind of stepping back and reevaluate your life and make sure that you take good care of yourself. And that is it for today. I just want to thanks for having you watch my channel, like and subscribe, and I will see you guys later. Bye.